Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today, it seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at Infowars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Secret is a secret government that worship an owl. They practice witchcraft and harness their power. Pedophiles rape little kids for energy. It's satanic ritual, WTC. R.I.P. They lit the Pentagon on fire. That's lighting the pentagram on fire. All these bodies for what? So you can scare everybody.
Okay, we have a prodigy of Mobb Deep joining us. And, of course, themostinfamous.com is his website to find out about concert tour dates. Dallas the 14th, Houston the 13th. But I don't know why we always plug just where people are coming in Texas. We're all over the country on the AM and FM dial, XM, Global Satellite, and, of course, Shortwave and Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. We're going to be breaking down the financial news, the police state news. Catherine Albrecht is also going to be joining us, getting into the whole control grid. But we're watching complete meltdown begin right now, and it's 100% mathematical fact. With the fractional reserve banking black hole system, they've created that this is going to happen, so that is coming up. Don't forget, Infowars.com has the online video bookstore, and we've added some great new camouflage, Don't Tread on Me hats that are very popular, and the new Liberty or Death red shirts that are the most popular shirt we've ever offered. Those are all available at Infowars.com. And it is your purchase of the books, the videos that makes this transmission possible, and my growing news organization, and also the support of the sponsors. So again, Infowars.com. You can also subscribe to PrisonPlanet.tv and see the live show stream, not just hear the radio. And you can also then see all my films in super high quality. And tonight, a 45-minute to hour special broadcast at 7 p.m. Central with Gerald Celente and Mike Adams, the Health Ranger, in studio. Celente will be via Skype. We're going to have Mike Adams in studio because he's moved to Austin. With so much to talk about, Mike Adams is popping in live, coming up here in about 10, 15 minutes. And Prodigy has agreed to come back up in the near future to really do a detailed interview because I want to. There's so many points I want to get to. Now, running through these fast, sir, we've seen rappers in the media demonized lately, and you were one of the only people to actually come to their defense for calling out Obama. What's your view of President Barack Obama?
I mean, my view on him is that, you know, number one, you can't be a president of the United States unless you're part of this bloodline that they got going on that goes all the way back to, you know what I mean, European royalty. You know what I mean?
Who believe that they're related to Jesus and Mary Magdalene. They're completely delusional.
Yeah, exactly. You know what I mean? So they got this bloodline going on, and whether people believe it or not, it's very real. You know, you will not be an American president unless you are linked and part of this bloodline. And Obama is. You know, he's a part of that. That's why he was allowed into the door. That's why he was placed where he's at now.
Well, he's related to Cheney and Bush.
Yeah.
And by the way, they're all related to everybody else. That's been confirmed.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely a link. I heard a lot of people say, oh, well, all humans are related. No, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about, you know, first, third, fourth, fifth cousins. Like, I'm talking about very related. Like, this is your family. You know what I mean? Your mother is this person's cousins. And, like, I'm talking about real related.
Yeah, they would come to the family reunion that closely related. Well, it turns out that that Bush and Kerry, particularly, even MSNBC did a breakdown. It's like I got a French bulldog. It's super related to all the French bulldogs. I mean, it turns out they're cousins on every side in every angle. Third cousins, fifth, ninth, tenth, 15th. I mean, it's just all related.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, Obama's a part of that. And whether he knows it or not, you know what I mean? Because I don't know that man. I haven't got a chance to pick his brain. So I don't know, really. I can only assume, and I can only look at the facts. You know what I mean? And from what I see, you know what I mean? Whether he knows it or not, you know, he's down with this whole, you know, conspiracy, you know what I mean, to rule the world, basically. He's a part of it. You know what I mean? And you know, to brainwash people and to kill people, genocide, you know what I mean? Everything that's going on out here that is just so fantastic, you really don't want to believe it, you know, Obama's down with it. You
well, Prodigy, what about the fact that he increased the funding for the basically forced abortions and population reduction in Africa? I mean, that's the big litmus test for me, any leader, because it didn't matter if you're white, black. You know, when people are, when 52% of black people in America are never born, I mean, that is definitely being targeted. And Jesse Jackson talked about this until he ran for president and then suddenly shut up. For me, that's the litmus test.
Yeah, I mean, it's a lot of stuff like that going on, man. It's definitely a lot of stuff like that going on. And, you know, it's sad, man. It's sad that, you know, when the election time was going on, when, you know, Obama was running for president, I was looking at all the candidates, and, you know, I'm like, wow, this is really a black candidate. Like, you know what I mean? It was amazing to watch that, you know what I mean? Because, you know, I'm black, I'm proud of my heritage, and it would be nice to see that, you know what I mean? That would be a beautiful thing. So I'm looking at everybody, though, and I'm watching the, you know, the debates with the candidates when they debate each other and all that. And I'm really watching it close. I'm paying attention to what they're saying and what they represent. And I seen the dude, Ron Paul, and certain things he was saying, you know what I mean? And I was like, hold up. Ron Paul is the only one up there, like, really exposing people. Like, he's really saying something. Nobody else is saying nothing like him. You know what I mean?
And the whole media came after him. One of my staff got a professional poll call the other day, and it was computerized, and they had the Republican candidates 1 through 7 with Ron Paul at the end. He tried to vote for Ron Paul, and it wouldn't let him vote. And they've caught Fox News dubbing in boos over him when he wins the big straw polls. Absolutely. That's where you can tell. If the media is behind somebody, then you know they're bad. If the media is against somebody, you know they're good.
Exactly. You know what I mean? So I had put it out there. I started doing interviews. They were like, yo, Prodigy, who you voting for Obama? Because it was a popular thing in the rap community. So, oh, vote for Obama, the first black president. He'll be the first black. You know, that was real popular, and a lot of people just followed like sheep. You know what I'm saying? So they asked me on the radio, oh, who you voting for? I said, if I was to vote, I would vote for Ron Paul. You know what I mean? And they were like, what? They couldn't believe I said that. You know what I mean? Like, everybody in the hip-hop community, they were just like, oh, Prodigy, you crazy. The first black president, he's black. Vote for him because he's black. I'm like, you don't vote for a person because he's black, first of all. You know what I mean? You vote for a person, no matter what their color is, you vote for them because of their intelligence and what they say they're going to do and, you know, what they are doing. And you know what I mean?
Exactly. You don't judge somebody by the color of their skin, but by the character of their deeds.
Exactly. You know what I mean? So this is what I was promoting to people. And they tried to, like, almost demonize me or say, oh, Prodigy's crazy. What's wrong with this guy? He's just ranting and he doesn't know what he's talking about. You know what I mean? He's a conspiracy theorist, and he does this, and he does that. I'm like, wow, there's that many crazy people in this world.
Well, hey, look who's been proven right. Continued the wars, the torture, the spying, the banker behavior. I mean, it's like Bush 3 here, or I guess Bush was really part 3 of his dad, so I guess it'd be part 4, 5, Bush 5 here, because we all know that when Reagan was running things, that it was really Bush Sr. Talk about a wicked, wicked devil. On that front, running through a bunch of questions here, and I'm glad Ron Paul was on my list here. Let's talk a little bit about 9/11. What's your view on 9/11?
9/11 was basically a setup, you know what I mean, by the definitely by, you know, this thing called the Illuminati. You know what I mean? That's another thing I want to touch on real quick. Illuminati is just a word, first of all. You know what I mean? It means to be enlightened, you know, the illuminated ones or whatever, right? You know, the original Illuminati, that original concept, you know what I mean? It comes from, you know, the essence in Egypt, in ancient Egypt, you know what I mean? The original Masons, you know what I mean?
The Egyptian mystery schools.
Exactly. It comes from us. And they took our information, basically, and they're using it for evil. You know what I mean? So I just want to let people know the origin of this stuff. Like, they taking our history, our, you know what I mean, my ancestors' history, knowledge, information, and they're using that power, which is God's power, and they're using it for evil. You know
well, it is true that Egypt, 6,000 years ago or more, was the first with to set up colleges on astronomy, but also farming, but also political control. And then, of course, that's why we're buried in coffins. I mean, it's all Egyptology. And then that's what the Masons are, you know, or think they're hoarding the secrets of it. And then you have really the Illuminati being a modern branch of that. And really, it's a gang of people. And of course, most Masons or porch Masons aren't even aware of it. And it's an idea. They can see, we can. It's like They Live, John Carpenter. You know,
exactly.
They live, we sleep, and you put the sunglasses on, and now you can see. And
exactly.
What do they say when you can see? I got one that can see.
Exactly. You know what I mean? So that word is just a word. It's a concept, like you said, for a group of people that are running things. That's probably not even their name. Alex, you know what I'm saying? They probably go by a different name. They probably have no name, but who cares?
Let me give you their name. They call it the Council, the Supreme Council of 13, that sits above the Bilderberg Group. I've confirmed this by multiple high-level CIA and State Department people and Colonel Craig Roberts and others. I would never even say it till I'd gotten it confirmed over and over again. You notice the new Super Congress is a model of that, or a subgroup, as above, below in their rules. You have six House, six Senate, and Obama as the head of the Council of 13. Again, Jesus and his 12 disciples, the 13 colonies, they always repeat it over and over again.
Yeah, you know what I mean? But the bottom line is it's happening. It doesn't even matter what their name is. You know what I mean? It could be the round table of grand wizard dumbasses. Like, who cares what their name is? It's really happening. You know what I'm saying? So bottom line is, on 9/11, you know what I mean, what they did was they killed 20 birds with one stone. You know what I'm saying? That's how I like to say it. You know what I mean? Because they changed all kinds of laws. They changed all kinds of they changed people's mentality, the way they look at the world. They pulled off one of the biggest ritualistic murders, you know what I mean? That ever happened, you know what I mean, live for the whole world to see, you know what I mean. I put a line in one of my songs that you were just playing in the intro about how they lit the pentagram on fire, you know, in the Pentagon. That's a pentagram. They set fire that day.
It's the center of the Pentagon, of the pentagram, yeah.
Yeah, so it was on fire. Like, and they only do that in satanic rituals. They light pentagrams on fire. You know what I mean? So I think it was more than just, something hit the building or whatever. I think they really lit it on fire for a reason. You know what I mean?
Oh, they admit that wars are ritualistic slaughter. That goes back to the Romans with the gladiators. It began as a sacrifice, but instead of the priest cutting your heart out, we have people kill each other in the ring. And the ancient Greeks had human sacrifice. This stuff does not change. And for the outer initiates at Bohemian Grove, it's mock. But then for the inner initiates, it becomes real. And then once they've compromised you there, now you can engage in the mass murder and death openly. Now, I've read, and I want to see if this is accurate, that obviously you have a right to defend yourself, a famous, wealthy person. I mean, guys that, you know, that close donut shops at midnight are, you know, allowed to carry guns even in cities that have restrictions. And I've read that you got set up for having a gun to defend yourself, a multimillionaire, you know, probably 50 times over, I don't know. And that again, in New York, you're not allowed to defend yourself, and that's what they sent you to prison for, and that was basically done to punish you because of what you were saying.
Well, that might be a little extreme to say that. You know what I mean? People might have the wrong idea of what really happened. Everything is not, and this will help calm people down a little bit too with all the conspiracy stuff. You know what I mean? Everything is not a conspiracy. Some things happen because you did something wrong, and there's no big conspiracy behind it. You know what I mean? I did something wrong that day. You know what I mean? The street, the life where I come from, you know, it's dangerous, man. The environment where I come from is dangerous. And I'm out there. I'm not out there running around trying to hurt people. I'm not doing nothing.
But you have a right to have a gun. I think that law's wrong.
Yeah, but you know what? The gun was illegal that I had. You know what I mean? I have a right to have a gun as long as I follow the steps and follow the law and get it the right way. You know what I mean? The gun I was carrying was illegal. It was a legal firearm. I wasn't supposed to have it. I wasn't licensed to carry it, none of that.
No, but see, but there's only a few spots, Prodigy, where that's the case, and a law that's unconstitutional is null and void. I don't want to... Look, I would use this example if you weren't here, because it's a good one. It's true. You know the first gun laws were against black people in this country. After the Civil War, they said, we can't have those folks being armed, so it started. And... there's only a few cities, Chicago, New York, and others, where it's almost impossible to own a gun. For me, it is crazy.